Hello, welcome back. In the last lecture, we learnt about functions, right? And then overall, we are basically skimming through what about the basic concepts that you need in C programming language so that you can successfully customize your VueGen script, right? And in the last video, we learnt about the function. And this is what we did. In the last video, we have created a function named add, and that add is taking two variable x and y. So here is another problem that I'm going to say. Let's say I have 100 functions like this, which I want to use in multiple different scripts, like, you know, in this script and in this script and in this script and so on. So in that case, one option is just going to repeat this function. So basically, you know, take this, you know, whatever this function name, and then basically you go to the other script, and then here you're also going to add that function. That is one way. So there is another mechanism by which what we can do, we can create an header file and then store that one. In this lecture, what we're going to do, we're going to teach you how to create a global functional function files. So how to create a global functional libraries so that we can use wherever we want. So basically, what you can do, this is the function, just take this function away. Okay, so take this function away. And then I'm going to this is the new script that I've created. Okay, so in this new script, I'm going to do LR output message, the sum is add 6 and 4. Notice that I do not have any function here. Okay, so instead of that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to open up my notepad and I put that function. Okay, so this is just a one function. I have some other functions, like, you know, another function f1, f2 and so on. Alright, so whatever functional that I think is going to be useful across script, I'm going to create a file, and that file name is something mylib.h. Okay, so what I did, so I create a file, and that file name is mylib.h. So mylib.h is a header file where I'm going to put all those functions, like, you know, my add functions, my f1 functions, f2 functions, f3 functions, so on. I put those things. I created that file and then stored it in my and stored that one in a file called mylib.h. Okay, so if you open this mylib.h, so this is going to look like this. Okay, so here the add function is there. Alright, and then what I'm going to do, I'm going to go to the, you know, on VueGen and go to this extra file. Then there's something called globals.h. In that globals.h, I'm going to include the location to my file. Alright, and then here, like, you know, the function is add. Okay, so basically, this function is defined in this header file. Not only this function, but also there are multiple different functions that I'm going to use it across various script. Those things I modularize and kept it there, and I call it here in the globals.h. Now I go to the action method, and here I just call that function. So this will return me value 10. So now imagine you have seen a lot of functions like web_url, web_link, lr_output_message. Those functions are defined in a file, and that file is called webapi.h. Okay, so in webapi.h, all those function definitions are being stored. And what we are doing, loadrunner, the virtual user generator is just including those files. So once it includes those header file, whatever functions are there, they can just simply call it, and that's what we are doing here. Okay, so when web_url, you are not defining the body, because that body is already defined, or that function is already defined in web_api.h. Right, so this is how using globals.h, using a header file, you can even modularize, you can keep your functions that is necessary across the script. All right.